Good afternoon, right? Good afternoon. So welcome to this afternoon consecration catch-up, right? And so this is what it looks like. Let's just say, well, hold on. Let me go back. My name is Rashida Monique. I'm the creator and the founder of the Daily Shift Broadcast. I'm also the national best-selling author, Rashida Brundage, in the book The Seeds of Hope that can be purchased at bit.ly/RBSeedOfHope. Go to the drop-down box, choose my name, and make your purchase. Yes. So thank you for being here. Thank you for joining. Thank you for watching the replay on whatever platform you find this video. Welcome to the broadcast. I know that we're not doing the daily shift and things as usual for the rest of July, but we're going to do what we can do. And so today I figured I'd come on in when I took my break. Instead of taking a nap, which I really need, if you can tell by my eyes. But I wanted to come in and just do catch up. So this is what catch up looks like. So you signed up for this 31-day prayer consecration and things happen, right? And you're like, well, man, I just should just give up because I can't do it perfect and God won't be pleased with my sacrifice. Stop there. Did God tell you he wasn't pleased, or do you just feel as if because your emotions lied to you, right? So let's just make a plan. Okay. Now, even though me and my family have been praying, there are some days that we missed this week, but we did good last week. So, but I'm going to start with the last week that I saw you, right? So Monday through Monday, there was a video, on YouTube every day for the consecration and on the blog at RashidaMonique.com. Follow there for all the scriptures, prayer topics for the day, and the fasting guidelines, RashidaMonique.com. Go there. So, excuse me. Did I leave my water? I think I left my water running out the office, like, trying to get people not to mind my business and for them to mind theirs. I left my water. But anyway. So, I did a video for the 11th, which was Sunday and Saturday. Monday was when mommy fell, and that's when everything just went awry, and I haven't recorded anything since. So let's start there. So this is what it looks like. You can do them all in one day. You can do them like double up on days or three times a day, because there are small topics, there are short scriptures. You can pray for more than one thing at once. This was set up so we'll all be praying and meditating and seeking God for the same thing on the same day. But listen, this is your consecration and your family's consecration, and so these things will get you caught up so that you won't feel pressured, and so that you don't, so that you can make sure you get everything in, right? That you're not the last day feeling like you failed yourself and failed God, right? So on the 11th, the last video was deliverance from addiction. We pray for deliverance of addiction, addiction to food, addiction to drugs, addiction to sex, addiction to TV, whatever thing that we put before God and try to fill our holes in our the traumas and soothe our souls with, instead of going to God, the God of all comforts, right? That was the 11th. On to the 12th, we was praying for spiritual growth. On the 13th, we're praying for spiritual maturity. On the 14th, we're praying for clarity. On the 15th, we're praying for bloodline salvation. On the 16th, we're praying for our communities. The 17th, our schools. The 18th, our businesses. The 19th, our ministries. The 20th, we're praying for governments. And on the 21st, we're praying for our church leadership. There are scriptures for all of these. You can find that at RashidaMonique.com. Go to the pinned video at the top, the pinned blog post at the top. There's a video, and under the video, there are two links, one for the calendar and one that gives you the focus and the scriptures, and the other is the guideline. So make sure you go there, download them, or print them however you want to access those. Okay, so today is our catch-up. So you would take time. I'm not doing that on this video. One, because for some reason after revival, because I was going between cars, I think my portable Bible is in the car. I mean, is in the house, and not in the car. And I didn't want to write all that right quick because my break is only 30 minutes. So I want to be able to woosah a few minutes after I talk to you guys, okay? So, read your scriptures, and go through these topics. So let's go ahead and pray. These are the topics that we're praying for today. Lord, we praise and we thank you for your goodness, your mercy, and for your kindness. You have been great. You have been kind and merciful, God. There is none like you. Lord, we ask you to show us how. We ask you first to forgive us for our sins and unrighteousness, and forgive us for our shortcomings. Forgive us, oh God, for not keeping up with what we committed to do at the beginning of the month. God, but help us to not just catch up, but be able to continue on in the place and be restored to the place that we fell from, oh God, according to your word, that we can be restored back to where we were taken off. And God, help us to forgive ourselves and not to walk in a false sense of perfectionist, a soft self-inflicted indictment, God, that we're not worthy of your goodness and of your greatness. God, we ask you to show yourself mighty in our lives as we go forth in this consecration, God, that we make it through to the end. You said it's not them that makes it the quickest way, God, but that we endure. So God, we are enduring hard times and tribulations and attacks from the enemy. You see us as we go through, God, so help us to stay the course. Help us to keep our eyes and our hearts and our minds turned towards you, knowing that you are the author and the finisher of our faith. So God, as we go forth, we ask you to continue to give us strength to grow spiritually, oh God, that you said that you would have us to prosper and be in health even as our soul prosper. God, let our souls prosper in this season. God, let the revelation of your word become clear to us in this season. God, give us a hunger and thirst for your righteousness in this season. Lord, bring us spiritual growth, God, that we not see pleasing others, God, but that we're pleasing you, that we go by your word, oh God, that we grow in leaps and bounds, that even our faith and our dedication to you, God, and our wisdom and understanding that you've given to us, oh God, will even surprise us. Give us spiritual growth in this season, God. We ask you to give us spiritual maturity, God, that we're not easily swayed, that we're not easily faltered, God, that when someone hurts our feelings, that we don't run away from you, that we won't run away from hard conversations. Make us mature in our marriages, mature in our relationships, mature in our families, mature in our friendships, we mature in our businesses. God, help us be mature in our church fellowship. Help us to be mature as we walk in the body of Christ and love our brothers and sisters. God, give us maturity in the spirit, naturally and spiritually. So in the name of Jesus, God, we're asking you to give us spiritual clarity, that we have a clear understanding of what it is that you're showing to us, that we will not see things in a fog, that we won't see things distorted. Like the blind man before he received his full sight, he said, I see men as trees, God, but we will not see molehills as mountains, and we won't see small things as monsters, God, but we will be able to see things clearly and be able to discern what it is that you're saying to us and what is happening in this season, that we'll be able to discern your hand and discern the attacks of the enemy, God, and discern what issues are in our flesh and be able to have clarity of what we are to do, oh God, in this season, in the name of Jesus. God, we're asking you to cover our families on today, not just save our soul, God, but we're calling for bloodline salvation. Save our children and our grandchildren, our spouses, our in-laws, God, save our husbands and wives, save our mothers and mother-in-laws, our fathers and father-in-laws, our children and our stepchildren, God, touch the blended family, God, let salvation go throughout the family, oh God, the children and the children's children and the children's children's children, according to your word, God, that they will be believers living for you like never before. Let your anointing flow down from the head to the youngest generation, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Let it flow like the oil flowed from Aaron's beard, God. Let it go down in the name of Jesus. God, we ask you to touch in our communities, God. You know our cities and our states are in trouble, God, that the enemy has run rapid over so many, that our views as what is right has been distorted, and we're calling wrong right and right wrong, God, but touching our communities, touch the city ombudsman, touch the representatives, touch the congressmen, touch the senators, God, touch the governors and the mayors, touch, God, in the name of Jesus, touch each and every one that are property owners in our communities, God, help us One, to love one another. Two, to take care of what you have given us to take care of. God, give us a sense of responsibility as to what it is that we are to do in the earth. Not just for us, but even those that have not been taught, oh God, to be able to help build communities. God, touching our schools, touch every principal, every assistant principal, every administrative, every counselor, every nurse. God, touch every person that learns, that serves in the lunchroom, that works in nutrition. Touch every teacher, every teacher's aide. Touch the bus drivers, oh God. Touch every coordinator in the name of Jesus. God, build up our schools. God, that we don't teach our children how to think the same, but teach them how to work with the skill set that you've given them. God, those that are in education, those that are being educated in our city, in our state universities, oh God, touch in our community colleges, touch right now in the name of Jesus. God, let your spirit go throughout the land, and those that are serving you in these campuses, God, present you to others, oh God. Let them be a light in a dark world. Let them change the atmosphere around them. Let them be atmosphere shifters. Let there be game changers in the education system in the name of Jesus. God, we ask you to touch our business, small and large alike. God, we ask you to allow income to come in. God, we ask you to let integrity come into these businesses. Let authenticity be in these businesses, oh God. Let them care about the communities that they serve. Let them care about the people that they employ. God, let them care about the people that they serve on a daily basis with their products and services in the name of Jesus. God, give them wisdom and understanding, clarity, oh God, as to what to do and how to do. Those that are waiting to start their business, oh God, remove the spirit of fear. Remove the spirit of perfectionism that they start, God, and go forth in faith of you, oh God, so that they'll be able to do what it is that you called them to do and be who it is you called them to be in the marketplace in the name of Jesus. God, we're asking you to touch ministries on today, God. Every ministry is open in your name. God, we ask you to have your way like never before. Cover them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, give them your strength and your power, your wisdom and your might. Give them your knowledge and your understanding, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, go forth throughout every aspect of their ministry, oh God, in the name of Jesus. The ministry to the young people, the middle-aged people, the old, God, those that are married, those that are single, those in the community, those that are in prison, those that are without, those that are in shelters, those that they see on the street, those that are without food, those that are homeless. God, you're able to show us how to minister one to another in the name of Jesus. God, we ask you to touch our government system. God, our government needs you, not just in America, God, but governments all over the world need you. We need your wisdom and understanding in government systems. We need your wisdom and understanding to be in the king's mind. God, you have said that the heart of the king is in your hand. Every prime minister, every president, every king, God, every queen, everyone that has authority, God, touch them now. Give them an ear to hear you and a mind to obey you. God, talk to them like you did the days of old. Talk to them in their sleep, oh God. Let them have a dream and call for the prophet. God, let them see what it is that you will have them to do, and let them the heart to do it in the name of Jesus. God, we ask you to touch our church leadership on today. Every pastor, every lay person, God, every minister, every person that comes forth that has influence in the church, in the body. God, help them to influence people to do what is right. God, we bind the spirit of stumbling, that we don't cause people to stumble as we try to operate in our flesh and operate in our emotions. God, but help us to be spirit-led. Help us to do what it is that you've called us to do. Help us to continue to put ourselves before you, oh God, to be able to hear your voice, to be able to see what it is that you would have us to see, and be able to communicate it to your people, and to lead them in plain paths, oh God, and lead them to you, not to us, not to our denomination, not to our desires, not to our servants. God, believe them to you in the name of Jesus. And we praise and we thank you for these days, God, and we thank you for what you have called us to do. And God, we thank you for how you hear us and you answer us, because you are a God that hears and a God that answers prayer. And we glorify you this afternoon, God. We honor you and we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you all for being here. Thank you all for watching. I hope this video finds you well, or wherever in your life that this video meets you. Continue to pray on your own. Let this fuel your fire to not just pray on your own, but if you've fallen off or missed a couple of days here and there, don't give up. Keep pressing. It's a sacrifice. Sacrifices are not easy. So now you have to go ahead and push through these next 10 days. Yes, these next 10 days, you can make it. You can do it. You can do it. So I thank God for you joining us. If you have not joined us, go head over to the blog, RashidaMonique.com, and join us. Your family needs it. You have a priest of your home. You have a responsibility. Yes, you have a responsibility to your family and your bloodline to go before God on their behalf. Job was blessed because he went to God on behalf of his children, right? He went to God on behalf of his children. He said, not just my sins, but the sins of my children, right? So we can go before God for our families and find success and positive outcomes to the issues of life. So I praise and thank God for you. You all have a wonderful and a blessed day.